This is Thomas Overall, pastor of Outreach Christian Fellowship. I'm so glad you're able to join us. Well, we want God to really bless you as you listen to this broadcast. It's one of our services that I know that God will richly bless you, that your life will be changed by the anointed word of Almighty God. Open up your hearts, open up your minds, open up your spirits, and let God's word minister to you and bring hope. You know, the word of God says, hope maketh not ashamed. And when we have hope in him, we're not ashamed. God always comes through. God bless you. Enjoy the message and let it change your life. Remember, we love you, God loves you, and there's victory in Jesus. Jesus, we give you the glory, we give you the honor, and we give you the praise. You are our source. And Father, I ask you to flood and flow down in this place. I ask you to change every life. Touch it with that hand of love, of mercy, of compassion, of grace. In Jesus' name, and we thank you, and we praise you. In the name that is above every name, we claim the victory, in Jesus' holy name. And everyone said,
amen.
Open your Bibles, please, to Acts. The first chapter, God is good, amen. Acts first chapter, ninth verse. Acts 1st chapter, 9th verse. Yeah. 9 through 11. And it says, after he said this, he was taken up as they were watching. And a cloud took him out of their sight. And it says, while he was going, they were gazing into heaven. And suddenly two men in white clothes stood by them. They said, men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up into heaven? This Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come in the same way that you have seen him going into heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Father, have your way. Glorify yourself. Let your word find its place and make a change in Jesus' holy name. And everyone said,
amen. You may be seated.
God is good, amen. When you got saved. When you got saved. Something happened to you. When you got saved. I didn't say when you went to church. Amen. Or when you, you know, you came up and shook a preacher's hand. I'm not even saying when you got baptized. I said when you got saved. And if you're not saved, you can be saved today.
Amen.
You can get changed today.
Amen.
You can exchange your old life for a new life today.
Amen.
See, it's your choice. It's your choice.
Amen.
But is there anybody that when they got saved, they got happy, they got joy, raise your hand.
Amen.
Is there anybody that when you got saved, you got peace, raise your hand.
Amen.
Is there anybody that when you got saved, a healing came along with your salvation, raise your hand. Anybody got delivered from a devil when you got saved?
Amen.
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 Oh, you worked it out. Amen. Praise God. See, whatever way that you got saved, that's the way that you know Him. As they stood there and they talked to Jesus and were talking to Him and and Jesus would break Himself down to them. Well, one thing He was breaking down to them was, like in the 16th chapter of John, which I asked you to read. When Jesus was breaking down the answer to them and talking about all the haters in the world. Amen?
Amen.
Because 16, verse 1 says, I have told you these things to keep you from stumbling. Uh-oh. Hold on a second. Hope her phone has not got on dead. Gotta get that to her. He said, I told you these things to keep you from stumbling. In other words, they will ban you from the synagogues. In fact, as a time is coming when anyone who kills you or persecutes you will think he is offering a service to God. They will do these things because they have not known the Father or me. But I've told you these things so that when they do happen, amen? When they do happen, he says, when it comes, he says, you're going to remember what I told you.
God is telling you these things in those verses to tell you, look, when that happens and when they say that they're doing it for God and country, they're not doing it for God and country. They don't know me. I was talking to Sunday school this morning. The love of God, you can't take that. When they say they love you, but they won't help you, that's not loving me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I didn't say when they say that they love you and you won't give them what they want. That's totally different. That's totally different. When God puts it on you and we all got a prideful thing that we don't really want to ask them. Nobody really wants to ask for help. Praise God.
Amen.
Because how many of you want to are independent?
Amen.
You're independent. You want to be able to, okay, God, I want to, me and you take care of this. I want us to take care of this. I want to take care of this. And sometimes you need help. And sometimes you need to get off the horse. And you need to humble ourselves. See, I think sometimes God puts things in our pathway to humble us. To say, look, you're not an island, baby. We all in this together. You're a part of the body. But if you won't draw from the body, you're going to receive atrophy. In other words, what you have is going to shrivel up. What you think you got is going to shrivel up because you're not growing from the body. Well, I'm drawing from Jesus. Jesus uses the body.
Amen.
Because Because there's going to be a time where God's going to use you to strengthen somebody else.
Right.
So why won't you receive the strength that God is using somebody else to strengthen you? Well, I don't think you don't get it. We're a family of Almighty God. Amen?
Amen.
When you got saved, God brought some stuff with him and gave it to you.
Amen.
He brought some stuff. He brought that peace. He brought that deliverance. He got rid of that devil. Whatever it was, he got rid of it and he put something in its place. And right then and there, you knew Jesus by this. And Jesus told them that this stuff was going to happen. So that when it did happen, they're not afraid. When it does happen, you're not afraid. You understand that, okay, God, you said this was going to happen. And since you said it, you made a provision for it.
Amen.
Say provision.
Provision.
You made provision for it. God said it was going to happen. God, you made provision. God, you're coming on the scene.
Amen.
No,
God. He's not ready.
You thank you. He's already in. He's God already here.
Amen.
He's God already there.
Amen.
He's there because you're there. He's there because you're there. He's not coming. You're not alone in a situation. God's there. He's there. He's there. So as they're down there and they're looking and they're contemplating this stuff and Jesus breaking stuff down to them and they're there, it's after the resurrection, and they're there, all of a sudden, Jesus takes off.
Right.
I like that. Jesus is the ultimate Superman. He takes off and he gets caught up in the cloud. In other words, to me, this is me, this is my thing. To me, he is so cool. He don't be like Superman like this, because Jesus is too cool for that. Jesus, they're talking to him. And the Uber of the Holy Ghost clown. Jesus don't even use the app on his phone for the Uber. The Father sends the Holy Ghost cloud to him. And he's talking to him, and he's telling them, he's breaking it down to him, look, man, look. I gotta go, and the Holy Spirit's gonna come, and all this other stuff. They break it down to them. The haters gonna hate you, and they're gonna say they're doing it for God's sake. They're gonna try to wipe you out. They're gonna try to hinder your blessing. But don't worry about that. I got your back. I'm with you in the situation.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
God with you in the situation. Amen. And he breaks it down to them, and all of a sudden the cloud comes and just gets right there on the ground. Big old cloud gets on the ground. And Jesus, like you said, going on. And as he's breaking out the door, all of a sudden the cloud lifts him up, okay? Jesus, cool. Amen.
Amen.
I'm sweating Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, he already done on the cloud. Jesus, look, let me be Jesus right there. And come, cloud, he takes off. And since the thing about it is, if that happened to you, you'd be freaked out too. I would. If I was in a park someplace talking to Jesus, and I'm talking to him, and all of a sudden a cloud comes down, I'm like, okay, I can explain that away. When he takes that step and gets in the cloud, and the cloud takes off, he takes off with it, I'm like, like, what is going on with this? And you're amazed, and it takes off. And God's up there, and he's gone, and he disappears, and you're amazed, you're looking at it, because you've never seen that before. Ain't nobody ever done that before. Amen?
Amen?
Ain't nobody ever done that before. Nobody has ever done that. Let's back up a minute. When you had no peace, but Jesus, when he came and he said he gave you peace, ain't nobody ever done that before.
Amen?
When you had no joy, and Jesus came and gave you joy, ain't nobody ever done that for you. You can try to get joy out of a bottle. You can try to get joy out of a pill. You can try to get joy out of a relationship, but it didn't last any. It had consequences, it had repercussions, it had side effects. After it was all over, you were talking to the porcelain doll. I'm talking about myself. You got your own thing going on. I'm talking to the porcelain doll, holding on to it from the backside. Head all down in the back. Do you know what it goes down there? Mm-hmm. It is something else that will humble you so much that your head is down there. God don't want to talk about that, all right? And you heaving up. Mm-hmm. And you heaving and you throwing up all kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. The same thing you put there, you're trying to throw it up. That ain't smart, is it? But it will take you to that place. It'll take you to there. But the thing about it, the same God that loved me so much and knew all that still delivered me.
Yeah.
And came and got me. And there's such a thing in my life to where I didn't do that no more. He delivered me from that.
Yes.
I tried to feel something else in my life. And he delivered me from that. He set me free from that. See, the thing about, regardless of what it is, regardless of the relationship, that you try to please somebody so bad, but they would just say, well, I love you, and they don't really love you. Because if they love you so much, why you got to pay all your money out on you? Amen. Amen. Me and Cynthia, we were sitting there watching Judge Judy or something. I got the show right here. And we were sitting there watching Judge Judy, this old OG, nice looking guy. Old, tall, good looking, shaved, very articulate. And there was this woman, she was young. You know, they had a weed going on and all of that and all that. And Judge Judy said he gave him the ruling, you owe him $5,000. And they walked out. Before they did, Judge Judy said, look, sir, you don't look like you that sick to just give her that money. He said, no, ma'am. And then one of her said, look, you, and she kept interrupting and interrupting. Judge, you say, no. Went out, and he said, look, please. And she went out and interviewed her. You know what she said? If he want to be with me, he has to pay to be with me. Hello? Mom? Mm-hmm. See, I paid to be with me. Now, see, the thing about it, that's not love by any means. That's not love. And we try in so many ways in even relationships that I got to pay out for you to love me. If they love you, baby, they just love you. You ain't got to pay out anything. If they love you when you ain't got nothing, they're going to love you when you got a lot. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
They don't love you. But Jesus said, hey, look, I'm letting you know concerning these things. I'm letting you know concerning things and what's going to happen. I'm letting you know that they're going to happen. So when they do, you're not changing. When they do, you're not changing. Do you know why you're not changing? The reason that you're not changing is because when I saved you, I gave you peace.
Yeah. Yes.
The reason I'm shaking, when I saved you, I gave you joy.
Yes.
When it happens, the reason I'm shaking is that when I saved you, I gave you love.
Yes.
And I showed my grace upon you.
Amen.
That's why you're not shaking.
Amen.
See. But the question is, why are you shaking it? Then why are we shaking? Because it was just like those that were standing there when Jesus went up. Where they're looking at that one situation, that one instant in time. And we're not saying, okay, and we're locked in on okay. And we're amazed. And we're gazing up. And we never, ever totally receive that in. That it's working all of our life. He said, the same way you saw him going up, he's going to come back in. In other words, look, dude, why are you still standing here? Why are you still standing here? Why are you still standing in that peace that he gave you? I'm not saying stand as it's rooted and grounded. Why are you still in the same spot? Why are you still in the same spot? He gave you peace. We all agree. Yes, he gave you peace. He gave you joy. He gave you this. He gave you that. Right? So the question is, why do we still just stand there fixed? Why? Why do we stand there like a stick in the mud? Why? Why? Well,
hey, baby girl.
Life's been hanging. You only hug before you leave. But why do we just stand there? Why? I'm going to tell you why. Because for some reason in our mind, and this is a world thing, that I'm going to lose something if I move. If I move, I'm going to lose something. Or, you know, if I get close to them, they're going to take something from me. They're going to take it from me. Ain't nobody taking you what God gave you. God gave it to you. Did anybody take your salvation?
No.
Why can't they take the peace then? Why can't they take the peace? They told him, said, look, man, what are you standing here for? You got an assurance that the same way he went up, he's coming back. Amen?
Amen.
You got an assurance the same way that God, when he came to you and brought peace in your situation when you were messed up and didn't know God and was doing what you wanted to do and you had no joy and you had no love and you didn't know how things were going to work out. Amen. The same way he came then is the same way he's going to come when your next situation comes.
Right.
Amen.
He comes the same way. He comes the same way with peace. He comes the same way with joy. He comes the same way with love. And those of you that had a deliverance, right? God is coming with deliverance.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
Glory to God. I ain't never had no devil. That's good. Amen. I never had to be delivered from nothing. Okay, that was good. I'm glad for you. Amen. But God has delivered me.
Yes, yes.
Glory to God.
Amen.
And I can shout because of that he did, because of my deliverance. I can shout because he put something in his place. I'm happy about that. What about you?
Amen.
What about you? What about you? Remember that sermon Jerry say? The pastor that preached the eulogy. And it was really, really good. He preached, and you know what? It was so. It was like, you know, this is what the problem is. God said, this is what the problem is. This is what the problem is. Because I've been searching for the answer of why children of God don't have joy.
Mm-hmm.
There's no joy in their salvation. I see it more and more every day. He said, this is the answer. This is the answer. We're too busy looking this way.
All right.
We're too busy looking at it. We're too busy looking at the situation. We're too busy looking at the problem. We're too busy looking at the bondage. We're too busy looking at what we got going on in the mess. We're too busy looking at this catastrophe or that or this. And you know something? We call catastrophe when it's not catastrophe.
Right.
A catastrophe is Puerto Rico.
That's it.
A catastrophe is the typhoons and all of that. We have a problem. We got to say we got a problem with this.
That's it. Oh,
but you can't see him.
Right.
You got to look up.
Amen.
Like Psalm said, I look to the heathen, overcome my help.
Amen.
My help comes from the Lord. I got to look up. And I'm not going to stand still and look up. I'm going to keep walking and look up. Because if I'm looking up, I'm expecting something.
Amen.
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 When I'm looking down, I'm not expecting anything. I'm looking as if it ain't going to change. Nothing's going to move. I can't make it. No, you can't because you're too far, you're too busy. We're too busy looking down.
That's right.
Instead of looking up. Amen.
Amen.
One thing it was that, and he said it was so true, and in the Old Testament church, there's a difference between now and the Old Testament church. The Old Testament church, they expected Jesus to come in time. We don't expect him to come. They expect him to come more. We have our day to come. I'm the root of the time, thank you, Lord. It's true. We don't, I can do it tomorrow. Tomorrow may never come.
That's all right.
Amen. I can do it tomorrow. God's saying that that is more. Whatever way he saved you, it was peace when he saved you, it was joy when he saved you, whatever it is when he came and saved you. You know something? We need to have that, and we need to walk in that and just not be stuck. If I move, I'm not going to be able to keep it. I can't keep it. That's part of your DNA there.
Amen.
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 Look at that. Good to cook it. That's DNA right there. Amen. And that's DNA right there. That's DNA over there. All of y'all got some kind of DNA. Amen.
Amen.
When you got born again, you got Jesus.
Yeah. Amen.
The most famous part of that DNA was peace. And it was joy. And it was love. And it was grace. Amen.
Amen.
And it was mercy.
Yes.
It's all in that DNA. So stop being like the world.
Amen.
Put your head down. I'm in this problem. Okay. He said, get the problem. And then he said, okay, what I do with it? Cast all your cares upon me, for I care for you.
That's it.
Okay. Who am I going to cast that on? It then said, look to the healed, which covers your health. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, you know something? Pastor said, Jesus was with me in my situation.
That's it.
Hold on, let me get free of Jesus. Jesus said, thank you. Let's go.
Amen.
And look to the healed. Look to the hill with expectation, that God is going to come in my life just like he did before.
Amen.
God's going to come in my situation just like he did before.
Amen.
And when he comes, like I said before, he's coming packing.
Amen.
He's bringing peace with him. He's bringing joy with it.
Yes.
He's bringing an answer with it.
Hallelujah.
What about you? Are you ready to receive it?
Yes.
Stop looking down! Look to the hill! With expectation! God is going to move! God is going to get you this word! God is going to make a way for me!
Yes.
Amen.
Stop looking down! Lift your head up. Lift your head up.
Amen.
Lift your head up. Praise God.
Amen.
You know, I got to share this. The Word of God says he's faithful just as he is. Amen.
Amen.
No matter what you've done, turn to Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus, forgive me.
Yeah.
And Jesus said, I love you.
Amen.
And he washes you and cleanses you.
Yeah.
And when he cleanses you, it's done.
Amen.
Lift your head up. Stick your chair back. And go on about your business.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
You got none of that sin anymore. Somebody said, ah, you did this. Oh, baby. Let me tell you, Jesus washed me from that.
Yes,
Jesus
right.
Forgave me for that.
Right.
Jesus took that all away. Yes. I'm walking on!
Amen.
I'm not going to continue in the same thing that I used to.
Amen.
I'm not looking down anymore in depression. I'm not looking down anymore in defeat. I'm not looking down anymore in my situation of poverty where I don't have. I want to look to Jesus!
Amen.
With a full expectation. God is going to come through for me. He did before. When it saved me. And when it set me free.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And there ain't nothing too bold. Hallelujah. Ain't nothing too hard for God.
Amen.
So I got a joy. And I can shout.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, other songs that you ask me why? How do I sing and shout?
Amen.
We sing and shout because I'm happy. Because I got joy. Because I got peace. That's why I sing and shout. Because He saved me.
Yep.
Set me free. That's why I sing and shout. And I choose. I said, I choose to walk in every day. God saying the answer is to your joy. Stop looking down and look up. And look up to the evil that comes to help. And look up with great expectation. The same one that saved and gave you peace is the same one that's going to come back and take care of my problem.
Yes. Amen.
And walk on with Him. Don't stay in the same thing. You walk in your joy. Walk in your peace. Walk in your deliverance. Walk in the promise that God gave you. Walk in the word that God spoke upon your life. God, if God spoke the word upon your life,
amen.
Walk in that. Amen?
Amen.
You walk in that. Okay. You walk in that, amen?
Amen.
That's what you walk in. You walk in. So your head will be down anymore?
No.
You want to skip to him. You think my day is too. It's kind of short. I put a tie on the Lord, have mercy, you know, before you put a tie on. Look up to Him. There's my help right there. I see it as Jesus. He ain't on the cross. Hallelujah. He's shining like the noonday sun. Amen. He's got it all. Whatever He said He would, He got it. Whatever I need, He's got it.
Amen.
No matter what it is, He's got it. And I'm expecting Him to move in my life. To get about, like I said, what they said in John 16, 1 through 4, to get about the haters. To get about the one that's trying to put you down. To get about the one that's saying you can't. To get about them. I'm looking up to what Jesus said. And He said, I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me.
Amen.
That's what He said, the promise God gave you.
Amen.
And He said, you know something? Since I'm 30, I don't need something else to have with me all the time.
Amen.
How can you say
it? Amen.
How can you say it? So what are you here going to do? Looking at who? Jesus. With what? Expectation. We need to spread the word. Spread the word. If you see somebody who got all the prayers on this, you say, what's wrong with you? Man, I'm saying, it's wrong. I got an answer. What is the thing? Man, you're ready for it. And Jesus, oh man, I already overlooked. Listen to me. Stop looking down. Start looking up. Things are going to get better.
Amen.
Start looking up. Start looking up. A change is going to come. Amen.
Amen.
This is Thomas Overall, Pastor of Outreach Christian Fellowship. I'm so glad you were able to join us during our worship service. And you know, the message that God gave me is so true. We need to stop looking down at our situations and our problems and our depression, whatever it may be, that is binding us and keeping us from living the full life that God has. And we need to look up with great expectation and look to the hill that cometh our help. For our help truly comes from Him. He is risen again, sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us. Look up and see the face of your loving Savior. Look up and understand that He has all things in control. Look up. Your help comes from above, not from below. You are the head and not the tail. If this has been a blessing to you, if the message has been a blessing to you, I want you to send us an email at ocflouisville@gmail.com. or want you to call us. Our phone number is 502-653-9362. If it's been a blessing to you or you have a prayer request, just reach out to us. We want to pray for you and we expect God to do great things in your life. Remember, your help is from above. Praise God and have a great day. Remember, we love you, God loves you, and there is victory in Jesus. God bless you the next week. This is Thomas Overall, Pastor of Outreach Christian Fellowship. Have a wonderful week. I look forward to if this has been a blessing to you, if the message has been a blessing to you, I want you to send us an email at ocflouisville@gmail.com, or I want you to call us. Our phone number is 502-653-9362. If it's been a blessing to you or you have a prayer request, just reach out to us. We want to pray for you and we expect God to do great things in your life. Remember, your help is from above. Praise God and have a great day. Praise God and remember, I love you, God loves you, and there's victory in Jesus. Remember, we love you, God loves you, and there is victory in Jesus.